Hey guys, it's Aja the Diva. Okay, it's so much drama in DeKalb County right now. I don't know what's going on, but I want to know what's going on. Every time I turn on the news, I turn on the radio, DeKalb County and our CEO is in trouble. That's what it looks like. So I brought in a fantastic attorney. Hello, Dolly.
Hello, Sasha.
All right, now her name is Tanya Miller, and she's just not glamorous and fabulous looking. She got this going on, and she's going to break everything down for us. All right. And just so you know about Tanya, she's a former district attorney. She deals with criminal, right?
That's right. Okay. I do all criminal.
Okay, where's your office is located?
My office is located in Centennial Tower on the corner of Spring and Peachtree.
Wow, Centennial Tower. All right, now, what's your phone number over there?
404-419-6369.
Okay, all this stuff that's going on with CEO Burrell Ellis, right. All these indictments, what does this mean?
Well, this means that Burrell Ellis is charged with 14 very serious crimes.
Can you start telling me about some of the crimes
and
the charges?
Sure. The lion's share, most of the charges deal with extortion and theft, or attempt to commit extortion and theft.
Wow.
And essentially, it's as bad as it sounds is really how bad it is. I mean, it's important to remember that an indictment is not evidence.
Right,
okay? It's
right.
Just a charging document. It's an accusation. But the charges, if they are true, concern questions about whether or not Mr. Ellis attempted to gain political contributions in exchange for contracts with the county, and that's a big no-no.
So now, how do we know that this is true? This is like someone saying, I gave Sasha money to play a song for me, and I'm saying, no, you did not do that.
Right.
So it's like my word against their word. So what type of evidence do you think that they have that they're bringing all these indictments down?
Well, we don't know yet exactly what kind of evidence they have. We know that the evidence could include wiretaps.
Oh, God. Oh, Lord. Okay.
It's possible. Okay. And when you have public corruption cases like this, it's not uncommon to have wiretap evidence. I don't know if that is the case.
Okay, wait. Let me ask this question.
Sure.
When the FBI goes into your home, so it's really a huge possibility that the FBI have been listening, right?
Well, it's not the FBI.
Okay.
In this case, it is the investigation is generated from District Attorney Robert James's office. So it would be DA investigators and other law enforcement officers in DeKalb County. But state investigators can conduct wiretap investigations, too.
Oh, my God.
It's just as serious.
Oh, my gosh. Okay.
Don't know that, but it's a possibility. So, you know, we don't know whether or not they have cooperating witnesses, people who have, you know, some criminal exposure themselves, who are doing this or giving testimony in exchange for leniency from the district attorney. Again, we don't know what documents they recovered during those searches.
This could be a really, really long process, couldn't it?
It could be a long process.
Okay, now, we have the governor that's getting involved. Why is the governor getting involved?
Well, the governor gets involved anytime an elected official gets charged with a felony.
Okay.
There's a state law that requires the governor to appoint a commission to determine whether or not the charges against the public official relate to his office or would affect adversely the people who he's elected to serve.
So does it look like he's going to be pulled out of office?
It's quite possible. I think you would be hard-pressed to say that the charges don't relate to his office. I mean, he is accused of using his position and using his power and authority with the county to try to get political contributions.
But now, to me, isn't that saying that I'm guilty? You're saying that I'm guilty. You're removing me from my job. Does that mean he still will get paid or no?
He will still get paid.
So he will still be paid?
He will still be paid.
So what if this goes on for 2 or 3 years?
He's entitled to be paid.
Wow.
He's entitled to be paid for the reason you just cited, that he hasn't been convicted yet. So until he is convicted or found guilty, he still will be entitled to receive his salary. Now, he can also, without the governor, volunteer to be suspended. We don't know if he's going to do that yet. He has 14 days to decide whether or not he's going to volunteer to be suspended while this is pending. Or if he doesn't, then the governor will appoint a commission.
Okay, so now they're saying that Commissioner Lee May will take over. Now, how is that determined? Why is he the person?
Well,
I mean, I don't know how that works.
Right. It's usually done when things like this happen. There are local rules in place that kind of have succession, for lack of a better word, already determined. And because of Lee May's position, he is, by the law and by the rules in DeKalb County, the one that would take over if Burrell Ellis, for whatever reason, couldn't do his job.
So what do you think? Well, can you tell? I mean, if you were representing him, I mean, what do you think?
Well, it's too soon to really formulate an opinion legally. If you're asking me legally what I think. What I think right now is that he is innocent until he's proven guilty. Mm-hmm. He's entitled to the presumption of innocence. The indictment is their charges, their accusations. I frankly don't believe that the district attorney would bring charges like this if he didn't believe that he had enough to prove these charges. However, you have to let the process run its course.
I'm like, oh my God. Her name is Tanya Miller, Law Offices of Tanya Miller, former district attorney. She handles criminal. Her phone number is 404-419-6369. See, Sasha had to ask an attorney. You know what I'm saying? Thank you, darling.
Thank you.